Hey, V-Team, happy Monday, and thanks for tuning in. It's the start of a new month and the perfect time to check in with V-Teamers around the business to find out what's new in their neck of the woods. Starting with some exciting news from our Satellite Solutions team. You may be familiar with names like Cow, Cell on Wheels, or Mouse, micro outdoor use satellite equipment. Well, today, we're thrilled to introduce you to the Reduced Ambulatory Contraption Creating Our Own Network, otherwise known as Raccoon. It's lightweight and battery-powered for maximum portability. Raccoon is ready to give our frontline the ability to squeeze into even tighter areas to provide the reliable network we're known for while making a Zendaya-esque fashion statement. The innovation doesn't stop there. You may remember a recent episode that featured our response teams deploying a robot dog during some training exercises. These mechanical mutts take the lead when a situation becomes too dangerous for their human counterparts. That story got us wondering, what's going on behind the scenes to make sure our capable canines are ready for action? We caught up with Jason Volk, the Technical Operations Manager for the Executive Briefing Program in Basking Ridge, to find out.
When people think about robot dogs, they tend to focus on the technology. At Verizon, we know caring for the dog part of the equation is just as important. We spend a lot of time and energy keeping our dog happy and healthy. Creating routines is key. He won't do anything until he's had his breakfast. We go for a long walk every morning.
Come on, bud. Man,
what did you eat?
Red, get back here, buddy. Come here. And then it's time for obedience training.
Sit, boy. Good boy. Spin, boy.
Good Red.
And then a nap in the afternoon so I can get some work done. And then it's playtime. He's very social and loves meeting new people.
You want to give him a pet?
But if you see him around the building, don't give him any table scraps.
Good boy.
And he's really become a part of the family.
He plays fetch, very obedient. He'll even wag his tail.
Who rescued who? Am I right?
Thanks, Jason. And when it comes to innovation, the Up to Speed team isn't sitting on the sidelines. We want V-Teamers everywhere to truly feel like they're a part of our family and part of our show. With that in mind, we're introducing Up to Speed 3D. This new way of watching your favorite lunchtime Verizon news program will make for a more exciting and immersive experience. So, dust off your favorite pair of 3D glasses and be sure to tune in to our upcoming episodes. Until next time, you're up to speed!